Have you ever looked out on a body of water in the winter and wondered what was going on under the ice? While you're skating across the surface of the ice, life continues underneath of the ice throughout the winter. Lakes like Scugog that don't freeze at the bottom are in their own little world. They're isolated from the surface and factors like the wind. One thing that can change quite a bit once winter rolls around is the oxygen level underneath of the ice. So just like humans, fish and other organisms that live in the water require oxygen to survive. But when the ice freezes the lake over, there's no more opportunity for oxygen to diffuse into the water from the atmosphere. In addition to that, the snow that blankets the ice acts as a barrier to light entering into the system, and so photosynthesis by primary producing organisms like algae and plants can't continue as well. And so while there's no new supply of oxygen, the organisms living in the water continue to use up the supply that was there, and so this can be a problem as it decreases over the season. So some types of fish require relatively low levels of oxygen, like the carp, whereas other species like walleye require relatively high amounts of oxygen to survive. Our ongoing research with the Scugog Lake Stewards in collaboration with researchers at York University is trying to determine how oxygen changes under the ice. There's very little information on changes in the winter in Lake Scugog, and so understanding this will be important for tracking and understanding how the lake functions throughout the entire year.